Hello everyone, my name is Noah, and welcome back to Subnautica. The new infected update is now released. I just saw it just like a couple hours ago. I'm really excited to get back on this. I did do a Subnautica Let's Play earlier in my channel, except that it was a hardcore series and it just got all buggy and everything, so I stopped the series. So we're just getting right back into it. So I'm really excited for this, so let's do this. I'm gonna go on a survival game instead of hardcore because it's still quite buggy, so hopefully I'll be able to fix the things on survival. But let's do this. I'm just so excited for this. When this game fully released, when it becomes fully released, I'm gonna be so excited. This intro is quite amazing.
Yeah.
Launch in 3, 2, 1.
I can still hear the manatees or something in the background. Here we go. Put this out. There we go. All right.
Greetings, survivor. Great job not dying. To assist you in further survival in emergency situations, you have been issued this personal data assistant. The interface visible now will organize your inventory, display currently available construction blueprints, and holds other valuable information. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with it.
Oh, baby. So let's see what we got. Oh! That's changed. Now they got all like the first ones down here. But that's now cool. The sea moth and stosun ingredients unknown. That's cool. Got the light pod. Got this log and then our data bank. The Ultra EEP suit, a single solution for a universe or infinite danger. You're currently wearing the AEP suit, a hermetically sealed personal environment designed to withstand the most extreme conditions in the known universe. Onboard temperature and hydration regulation compatible with a range of modifications for particular environments. Contextual heads-up display, biometric scanners, slimline build for maximum freedom of movement. And here's all the other stuff that I've read before. I'm gonna put that away. What do we got in here? So we got some water and nutrition blocks. Anything changed on the fabricator? It doesn't look to be. Oh, that looks cool. The gravisphere has been changed. That looks really cool. It looks like we're pretty far away from the Aurora. The Aurora suffered catastrophic hull failure. Cause unknown. Zero human life signs detected in 100 meter range. Alright, let's dive on in. Alright, what do we got here? We got some quartz right off the bat. Break limestone, might as well do that. Obviously get all the titanium we need. Oh, there's a lot of quartz down here. Is there one more? There is up here. I thought there was another one down here. I'm already 50 meters below the surface. I do want to grab this. Then we'll head immediately off.
Oxygen.
I should be able to make yeah. You feel threatened? There we go. Alright. Get some of this cooking. Some titanium. Some glass. And this we can immediately make an O2 tank. That's really good. We can eat one of these nutrition blocks. Nope. That still opens and closes without a showing. Alright. Do I have anything over here? I believe, yes, we need these sea clusters. Can I grab a bunch? Oh yes I can. I think that's, oh no, that's not full, but that's a pretty good amount. Now, I will let you guys know that I have not played this since my last hardcore episode. So, it's been a while since I played this. But, like I said, I'm just so excited to get back into this because I love this game and I really hope when the full game comes out, it's just going to be, well, I just really hope it turns out really awesome. So now we can make some lube and some silicone rubber. I'm gonna make two of those. Make one of these. I think that means I'm gonna have one extra. Okay, can I make a knife? Yes, I can. Get that out of the way. I can make another one if I wanted to. Fins, I kinda want that. So that means we're gonna have to go and get more lube.
Detecting increased local radiation levels. Trend is consistent with ongoing degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core due to damage sustained during collision. Continuing to monitor.
Thanks for letting me know. Always good to know about that. Seeing all these different things. We got a current generator and then lube. Just regular lube. I think I just want to grab a bunch more though. So I can grab a bunch. I say, well, we have one in there, so I say another 8. Come on. Come on. Pick it up. Pick it up. There we go. I can cut creepine with knife. Oh, jeez.
30 seconds.
Creepine sample. Can't I eat that? First creepine. First creepine eaten.
Oxygen.
I know about the oxygen. Oh my goodness, this game, man. Alright, so we have fiber mesh now. I want to make another silicone rubber. And we can make a reboot breather, which is actually really nice, and a dive reel. Alright, just how much do I have? I have 7, so I can make one lube and 2 silicone rubber. Now always be handy to have. And make another glass. Why not? I'll keep the rest of the quartz for computer chips. So now we're gonna make some fins. Have those in our inventory. And what do we have in here? Some more stuff. Okay, so right now, what we really need to do, if I can remember, is we need to make a welder. So we need to make some magnesium, which we're going to need salt, crash fish powder, and titanium, I think, is all we need. Ooh, some copper. Your survival has just increased by 11% just by grabbing one piece of copper. Oh, because that is true. I need a battery. So I think I just need two acid mushrooms for that. All the memories. Any crash fish powder in here? Doesn't look like it. Pick this up while I'm going up. More copper. Always a pleasure. Alright, well, that's our main hunt right now. It's crash fish powder. I can't even talk. Question is, where is some? Grab some more titanium. Don't want to go too close over there. More quartz. Oh, this. Oh, geez. Oh, God.
30 seconds.
Oh, creature egg? Really? That's not what I wanted. That looks kind of weird, because he was, you could see him out of the thing. So that's new. They don't just explode once they get out. They take time. They actually go near you, and then they explode. That's new. Oh, jeez. Dodge and weave. Aha, crash fish powder. Now I gotta get out of here before I drown. More titanium. Always a pleasure. Now I just gotta get back to my life pod, which is smoking. Actually, it's really smoking. Why is it smoking that much? Alright, hopefully we can fix that by going and repairing it. Oh yes, you can see all the smoke right here. Alright, so... do I not have enough magnesium? Alright, give me another one. Oh wow, we have plenty of titanium. And we make a battery. Alright, where's another salt deposit? That's all I need. Then we can make a welder. That's deep. Like, I mean, it's cool to do these all in video games, but in just reality, like, in the real world, I would never do this. I am really afraid of the ocean. Well, not really, I would say afraid, but I don't like being in open water. Like, if I'm in a boat, like in my life pod there, I would be okay. But when I actually go in to swim, like, going into just free swimming in the ocean, oh my god, that's when it's just like, I get very scared. Because that's the thing, you don't know what's below you. Unless you're in something like the safe shallows over here, which, as long as you can see the bottom and see what's coming, I think I'll be okay to swim in this. But if I was like in the deeper parts of the ocean, that's a big no for me. There's a salt deposit. It's really hard to see. I'll grab more of these mushrooms. I'll make another battery. We had to go over 100 meters away in order to find just one salt deposit. Well, at least one that I can see. Let me just swim by you guys. I mean, no harm. Just want to get to my life pod and just start making more materials. Magnesium, there we go. Tools and a welder. And a scanner, absolutely. I would like that. I'll make another battery. Alright. Do like the cool little animations. Oh, looks like the thing is done. Now it's cool that these lights light up in order to do that. Oh no, it's also cool is that now you can self-scan yourself. So let's see how it is for me.
Performing self-scan. Vital signs normal. Detecting trace amounts of foreign bacteria. Continuing to monitor.
Okay, so, and as you can see on the scanner, I'm already infected. So, just by jumping in and not even being in there for a day, I'm already infected. There we go. Now we gotta repair this so we can get messages.
Doctor, a new message has arrived.
No more smoking here.
Playing message.
This is an automated bounce back from the Aurora mining vessel. Your distress signal has been received. An emergency relief team will be dispatched to your location. Estimated arrival time, 9:09:09 hours.
Okay. They increased the thing that shows down on the bottom. They looks like they made it kept it there longer, so that's good. Alright, hull integrity okay, secondary systems online, flotation devices deployed, environment, uncharted ocean planet, oxygen, nitrogen, atmosphere.
Degradation of the Aurora's drive core may cause a quantum detonation. Calculating risk assessment, death by malnourishment, 7%, by physical injury, 11%, by exposure to radioactive crash site materials, 19%. If the drive core is breached, probability of death increases to 65%.
Okay, that's quite a mouthful to do. But anyway, back to here. Waterborne bacteria levels high. Attempting to scan emergency frequencies. So, that's all the other light pods, I believe. Let me have some more water. Always good to have more water. I might as well just make a titanium ingot, because I know I'm going to need this later. But it's not worth carrying it around with me with all this titanium. So, let's just put all this in here. Got an extra battery. Alright, and let's see if we can find any scannables. One thing that's cool is the geology one. Well, not really cool, but it just gives you a reason to scan. Ooh, some lead. Alright, right now we want to find these cargo boxes that have blueprints in them. Well, that I do not know. So let's break open all these to get materials, because I mainly want copper. Salt. I need copper because the sea glide is next up on my list. You just need to find one of those boxes in order to... There's one. Sea glide. Sea glide, one out of two. Alright, so we need to find one more. If I were one of these, where would I be? Stalker. Metal Savage. Metal Salvage. Not Savage. Oh, are you coming after me? Oh, yes you are. Where's my knife? Oh geez, there's a lot. Oh, ouch! That hurt. Well, might as well use this, because that's why we have it. Even though it's not hardcore. Hardcore would be way more like, okay, just gotta be careful. I swear there was a box or something just right over here. Because once we grab that, then we should be able to make a sea glide. Grab another metal salvage. I think there is one over here. Aha! Oh no, that's the one I already grabbed. Alright, come on. That's another metal salvage. Well, we're heading more towards the radiation zone. Come on. Give it to me. So much metal over here. Okay, come on. Come on, give it to me. I thought I saw something weird there. Grab it. Grab it. Thank you. Ah, just a bunch of... lots of metal. Oh, more copper. Always take the copper. Ooh, you're a bladder fish. I remember they used to call you air sacs. But now they're called bladder fish. Oh, what's that metal doing? Alright, let me just check over here. How far are we? 300 meters. It's not really a big deal of how far you go away, it's just... like you just travel that far and it's basically like you find one right beside you. So it's like no point. Don't you dare attack me. Oh, you son of a gun. I know how to loop around you guys. More creep vine. Ooh, we got a wreck over here. Bits and pieces of the Aurora. Ooh, there's something there. Mobile vehicle bay. That's nice. Ooh, and a bioreactor. Always good to have those. Alright, doesn't look like there's anything else over here. Oh, wait a second. Ah, you're trying to hide from me. And a sea moth fragment. Well, oh, just from that angle, it did not look like a sea moth. Oh, lap counter. Might as well grab it. Man, this takes a long time to scan.
30 seconds.
Now, one thing I don't...
new blueprint acquired.
Yeah, it just says infected. Just one thing I've noticed that there's a problem with the self-scan is that you can't see your battery power on this. So...
oxygen.
There's your problem. Yeah, come on. Get up, I'm drowning! There we go. Ah, fresh air. And once I get a sea glide, it'll be much faster to move around. And just before I end this episode, I do want to find a sea glide. Is that one there? I swear that looked like one. Come on. Give it to me. It's around here somewhere. This game is kind of fighting against me. Does not want me to find the another sea glide fragment. And then I'm just going to be searching around and I'm going to find sea glide fragments everywhere. Come on. Come on. It's like there's gonna be one right in front of me and I'm just not gonna see it. This is so slow though. I think you swim faster when you have your PDA in your inventory. Already day two? We got some filtered water, got some cooked food, and some cured food. I'm gonna cook the peeper. I'm gonna make the bladder fish into water. The fabricator cooks small organisms while disposing of the skeleton structure, bodily fruit, and internal organ. This run room safe for human consumption. Alright, thank you. Sea moth, 1 out of 3. Mobile vehicle bay, 1 out of 3. And a sea glide is 1 out of 2. Okay, and a bunch of, bioreactor. On planets where organic matter is plentiful but sunlight is not, a reliable bioreactor will quickly prove the most efficient power solution. Multi-purpose habitat room, which we do not have yet. Alright, the sea glide, capable of speeds up to 10 meters per second. Replaceable battery, 13 meters per second. So the sea moth is faster than the sea glide. Sea moth is one person.
A new message has arrived.
Oh, there we go. I was waiting for one of those to come.
Message.
Light pod 3. Oh, that's changed. Collect some holes in our emergency sea glide, so if you're late for the rest of it, don't panic. Also, don't go. Sorry, I didn't get that. This is light pod 3 uploading our coordinates. We're plugging some holes in our emergency sea glide. So if
Warning, local radiation readings,
if we're late from the regions, don't panic. Also, don't go home without us. Seriously, react.
Matter drive core. A quantum detonation will occur with a probability of 85.5%. Advise observing a 1 kilometer safety range.
That's a big chance for that to happen. Alright. Well, I guess their sea glide damaged. Well, they have a sea glide, and I definitely want to go over there. So, I guess I'm going to head over to this light pod, and then we'll call it an episode. Because if this does not have a sea glide fragment, I'm going to be lost. Alright, come on. It's like we just run into one on the way there. Now remember, it's been 3 hours since we've landed, so all this was 3 hours later before, but it just sent us that message, so I don't know how this happened, but sea glide. And a PDA. Abandoned PDA.
Integrating new PDA data.
Ooh, what is this? High capacity tank. Ooh.
New blueprint acquired.
I can't scan it. What is that? Oh, that's cool.
Oxygen.
Well, two things I've noticed. One is that it looks like you're gonna have to find different data banks or something. I've seen those in screenshots, but I didn't expect them to be in the game right now. But you need to find these in order to find those blueprints for the workbench. And also, now is exceed multi-purpose room, since I mentioned it in the bioreactor, it's now got that there. Well, that is really cool. We also have our signal there, but nothing really much there. So, what do we need? Deployables, battery, lubricant, and copper wire. I think I can actually make that right now. So, copper wire. And a sea glide. I can actually make that as well, too, but Sea Glide! That's gonna help so much. The Sea Glide will increase your effective exploration range. For your safety, please pack supplies for long journeys and always stay within 5 kilometers of the nearest life pod or habitat. Oh, I didn't do any cool animation. Alright, well, anyways, I'm gonna leave that episode here. That is episode number 1 of the infected version of Subnautica. Well, the infected update. So, more episodes to come. And just excitement over the horizon. Alright. Thank you very much for watching. Love you guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.